that's when it all started from. So slowly I set my company, and you can call it luck or hard work, it just started to flow. And we kept working really hard, me with my team, we kept working really hard. We got different inquiries, different clients. I remember we had a client who wanted just white colors in her entire house, you know, just white. And from pastel colors to really dark colors. And we had children who wanted all the possible colors in their room. So they wanted basically a rainbow. So we gave them what they exactly wanted. And I think we did a really good job in it. This, kidhar to use karenge. And when I flew back and, I was in my office, I was with my team. I finalized that, okay, we can use this in such a luxury project. And like normally, you all must have seen the ARC sofa on the living room. So that was actually inspired by the deck ARC. It's very common to have, you know, three sofas in a vertical or a horizontal manner. But to have a different...
So Tanisha, what exactly, like, you know, what is your favorite part if I consider as a villa, which is your favorite room to get decor, like, you know, which is the favorite room?
In this project especially, like I mentioned, the entire house is my designer, the entire house is my favorite. But if you just tell me to choose one, I mentioned the dining room, the formal dining room is just right at its place. So that's the, space which is really my favorite. The formal dining room in this project.
And what are the hardships you come through while you are into interior designing? What are the hardships? Are the clients or is it the room, and how you deal with it? Like, what are the hardships you come forward?
So to be honest, every profession has hardships.
Scenario in India, in Bandra, Santa Cruz. China, and that would be my dream.
As you know, Gauri Khan is the biggest interior designer.
Yeah.
So any inspiration from her, if you can talk about it?
Yes, she's definitely an inspiration because, you know, she's an investor restaurants, and you know, she just completed a restaurant recently. Yeah, okay. So all her designs, the Earth restaurant which was done, the every design, every detailing was so accurate. And I had actually gone there just to see the interiors, to just to get my inspiration. So she's definitely an inspiration.
And ma'am, you must have traveled the world wide as well. So what scenario to find abroad in India? I mean, how far
the all the when you say design is such a vast industry that every individual has a different design. But even for abroad, all the designs that they're Italian designs, Indonesian designs, all the designs are very different. So it's very hard to compare any design, but each design is really good in itself.
All the industry is getting funding and investors. What about the design?
Can come in the commercial projects, but not much in the residential. Yeah, that's our vision, right? First, we want to grow in India itself. We want to do good in our area, and then we want to, widen our work to Dubai or UK, US, everywhere.
And do the government support the entrepreneurs? I mean, in the government as such.
The government definitely does. Interior design, especially the kind of designs we are more into the luxury projects. So again, like I said, we need more of support from the clients than anything else.
Till now, how many projects you have done with and any upcoming project you would like to talk about?
We've done around 50 odd projects. And those 50 odd projects are right from the 5 years where I started, from 2 BHKs to studio flats to a one bedroom and penthouse, duplex, everything. And the upcoming projects that we are going to recently do, 7 BHK in Thane area, and that's basically like two houses of 3 BHK coming together for one 6 BHK. So that's our upcoming project. That's again a luxury project. We are as of now doing a commercial project in 1 BHK, that's again a 4,000 areas of square feet. So these are the big two projects we are as of now working on for the next 3-4 months.